By the end of this video, you will be able to make a crouching system like this. To make a crouching system, we need to first understand how our movement system works. When the player presses WASD keys, our input manager, using Unity's new input system, will handle the raw data and convert them to a vector 2 attribute, with each number ranging from 0 to 1. Our player controller will then make use of this vector 2 attribute and determine our target speed. Then, the player controller will move our player rigid body with a corresponding speed and send the related speed attributes, our current X velocity and Y velocity, to the animator controller in order to animate our character. Hence, for the crouching system, we only need to change our target speed to crouching speed while playing a different set of animations. Previously, we made our own input action map using Unity's new input system. We're gonna open that up and create a new input action. I'll name this one Crouch. The action type should remain button. Then head to the binding section. For the binding path, I'm gonna bind it with the left control key. Save it and close it. Go to our input manager. We need to set up the input action just like last time. First, create a public read-only field called Crouch. Then, create a reference to the input action we just created. Find the actual input action in our current map. Make sure you have the spelling correct. Bind the callback function to the input action event. And finally, create the callback function. Since our input action is set to button, we have to read value as button. Right, save the file and we're done with our input manager. Now, for the animation part, head to mixamo.com. We need 5 different animations for our crouching system, so search for crouching idle, crouched walking, walk crouching right, walk crouching left, and walk crouching backward. You may notice that these animations have different upper body motion, but it really doesn't matter, because we're going to mask them when adding the weapon system anyways. Once you've found these animations, remember to check the in-place checkbox and download FBX for Unity without skin for each of them. After downloading all of the animations, import them to our project. First of all, we need to rig the animations. Select all of them, choose humanoid, and for the avatar definition, choose copy avatar, and use the avatar we created ourselves. Click apply and save. Rename each animation. Then, for each animation clip, rename it, set it as looping, and bake transform rotation and position. Click apply to save them. Head to our animator controller. Let's create a new state from blend tree called crouch. And also create a new bool parameter and name it crouch. Make a transition from base state to crouch and another transition from crouch to base state. For the first transition, uncheck has exit time. And for the condition, set crouch to true. For the second transition, uncheck has exit time, set crouch to false. And the interruption source should be next state. Double click to go inside the crouch state. The blend type should be 2D simple directional, and the parameters should be X velocity and Y velocity. Then add 5 motion fields. And fielding the animations we just imported. Now, I want the crouching speed to be 1.5 meters per second, slightly slower than the normal walking speed, which is 2 meters per second. Technically, you can use any speed you want for your game, but I just find these speeds work well with the animations. So, just last time, we need to set our position X and position Y, which is our X velocity and Y velocity. For crouch idle, since the player is not moving, both of the parameters should be 0. For crouch forward, the player should be moving forward at a speed of 1.5. So position Y should be a 1.5. Crouch back should be the opposite of crouch forward, so negative 1.5 in position Y. The player should also move left in crouch left, so negative 1.5 in position X. And finally, crouch right. Done! Remember to save the file. Finally, it's time for our player controller. First, we have to create a variable representing the hash ID of the crouch parameter in our player controller. I'm gonna name it crouch hash. Then, we need to convert a string parameter to our hash ID. Done! In our move function, set a target speed to 1.5 when a player has pressed the crouch button. At last, create a function called handleCrouch, sending the crouch information to our animator controller. Remember to place the handleCrouch method inside a fixed update loop. All done. In the end, if you find your animations unsatisfying, you can always go back to the animator controller and tweak the animation transitions. And you can even make your character teabag out of this.